finished. company.
You lose!
There's no end to them. The whole bloody army's here. Stand back, Joshua. I'm summoning Ifrit.
Stop, Clive. You mustn't. We still have a long way to go. If you tap your strength here, you'll have none left to destroy the heart.
Then you'd rather die?
She's not alone.
Surprised to see us.
How did you?
Gav. He told us exactly where you'd be. Even sniffed out a crack in the castle wall. And when we saw the heavens come crashing down, we had no choice but to believe him. It's been quite a day.
To what do we owe this honor?
A debt I would see repaid.
Prince Dion. It's good to see you well.
So, this must be Ifrit. Your uncle bade me give you a message. Listen to your heart and guide your steel true. Your father would expect no less. That is all.
Thank you.
For everything, Your Highness.
Dion, please.
You do realize the only thing we've freed so far is this wall from its foundations, right? Now, if your lord and ladyship's quite finished...
Well said, Gaff. We have work to do.
I don't suppose there's how I can say to make you change your mind. So I'll just tell you to stay safe. None won't take kindly to losing a best customer, especially after letting us carry all this stuff all the way to Ash.
And we wouldn't want to anger old Nan.
You mean, you'll buy summer offers? I've got some good stuff for you. Thank you. Oh, here you go. Is there anything else you need? Righto, here you go. All done then. You want us to make you something? All done then, no.
see, Clive. We're not alone. If we are to win the day, we must all play our part. And ours. Ours lies beyond those doors.
We fought long and hard for this moment. Sid's dream, our dream, is within our grasp.
We need only endure this final trial, and we shall. Together.
You all know what it is that awaits us beyond this gate. And we shall face it together.
Aye.
It seems our host would rather we remain. We'll stay them.
We will stay them. Go!
Just don't keep us waiting.
Thank you.
Joshua! Wake up!
Clive, is that you? This isn't stone here.
Welcome to our darkness. A rift between worlds wherein your kind might reflect.
Show yourself!
Grave and many are the sins of man. And we would have you know them. All of them. As fate has seen fit to deliver you home, consider this our welcoming gift.
It would seem we are trapped.
And the only way out is through Ultima. We find him and we leave.
Thank you.
you are to comprehend the full extent of your transgressions, we must go back to the beginning. When the world was still young, we visited upon it a miracle, magic, and in its light did all life flourish. Yet the price for this boon would prove heavy. A pall descended upon the land, painting the horizon black as night. Though we labored to forestall its spread, in this one endeavor, we stood powerless. And so we fled, that we might endure. Endure, that we might discover a means of salvation.
It was magic that caused the blight. What of the Mother Crystals?
I expect he'll tell us soon enough.
Salvation, alas, was not readily to be had. First, we would require a land unvisited by the stain of corruption. An unprecedented journey lay before us, one beyond the limits of our fleshly bodies. And so we cast them off. Thus, stripped to our very spirit, did we find our new paradise. A land as pure as driven snow, Valisthea. There would the true work begin, for the black crept yet behind us. And soon did we arrive at a solution, the illness having spread to every organ. There was but one escape from this fate. To start afresh.
With a new world. The one for which Barnabas labored. A paradise free from the blight where his God awaits. And where, if we only forfeit our wills and abandon everything we hold dear, humanity can join him. So, Ultima would have us follow in the footsteps of the king.
And follow we shall. For now.
To forge a new world would require not only power, but a constitution strong enough to wield it. Acquiring the first would be simple. untouched by the blight. Valisthea was replete with ether, and we had only to place jewels in her crown to claim it. Acquiring the second, however, demanded creativity. And so I cast forth the seeds of humanity.
You created us.
Is that not what gods do? We sowed the seeds for you, Mythos, all that you might one day blossom. And our future thus secured, we thought to slumber, though that would prove a grave mistake. For it was as we slept that man committed his greatest sin. He awoke. Alone in a world bereft of his god's radiance, he stumbled blindly, desperate for guidance. Finding no light, he sought to kindle his own. And from that single errant impulse was his will born. Having discovered himself at last, man turned his eyes inward and found he desired evermore that which only magic might afford. So wars were waged and brothers slain for custody over that dwindling resource. And the land, she wept tears of black.
He would condemn us for this. Surely he cannot be so blind to his own hypocrisy.
Not blind, just unwilling to admit the truth. Though we are one and the same. Valisthea cannot endure a second claim upon her being. The avarice of man drives her ever closer to destruction. But she may yet be saved by you. It is what you were born to do, why we nursed you and fed you, as your own mother should have. And now that you are fully grown, our Mythos, it is time at last for you to serve your purpose. To right your wrongs. If our sin is wanting to survive, then you are as marked by it as we are. The fault is yours. Our wills were born because you abandoned us.
And now, you would have us forfeit them. All for a place in your new paradise.
Do you imagine yourselves worthy of one? Mankind has no place in our world. Is this truly so difficult to comprehend? We only ever require you, Mythos, when the time comes to bid this wretched realm farewell. None shall follow, none shall remain.
What do you mean, none?
This is our world. Once the land's rebirth is complete, humanity will have served its purpose. Why would we continue to suffer that which has caused us so much vexation?
Because the land doesn't belong to you. It belongs to us all! What?
That is where you are mistaken. You own nothing but your precious will.
Brother.
I can't do this alone.
And you don't have to.
I grow weary of your descent. Now you must learn that this master will not tolerate disobedience.
My friends. My family. We have all suffered, all fought to survive. This world may be flawed. It may be broken. But it's all we have. And if we can't share it, I see only one other choice. You have to go.
You may have created us, Ultima. But it's time we lived on our own terms. This isn't your world anymore. It's us.
Bow down, offenders, hearts disdained. foul attaint may not be sublimed through gainstanding. Only with heads hung low is penance paid. O wretched mortals, incapable even of contrition. In fitting sea. Gifted this chance, and still you would raise your hand against the Lord.
What now? The darkness bends. He means to end us.
It wouldn't be the first time, but let's make it his last.
Your fate is inexorable. Surrender the vessel unto the darkness. Surrender it unto us. countless generations have we awaited this moment. Your struggles have made you strong, yet your soul remains heavy with sin. Absolution is nigh. Repent, and all shall be forgiven.
Tell me, Clive, how many lives have you saved since taking my name?
Fewer than we have ruined. Wherever we go, we leave a sea of tears in our wake.
These are the wages of your will, son.
What good are our choices when all they ever bring, all they will ever bring, is death?
There's no atoning, Clive. No matter how hard you try.
So why not leave it all behind?
Leave it all behind.
Somebody save me. Won't anybody love me?
I yearn, yet still she is not mine. Have I not given enough?
From will is born desire, and it is this which consumes you, rendering you incomplete.
Do you not see how the world bends and warps under the weight of your hungering hearts? What if it could all just go away? Just go away.
Clive!
None of this is real. Wake up. It's time to go home, Clive.
Clive.
That's right. You're my brother.
Brother?
remember who you are.
Clive.
Once more, lest you forget.
My name is Clive. Clive Rosfeld. Look, Ultima.
Even here, the light of the vessel's will cannot be quenched. And the phoenix, his trespass should not have been possible. Not possible unless he has been with Mythos all along. The mark of the phoenix, emblazoned upon his heart, made manifest by the power of will alone. The power of creation. Can it be? Are their wills truly so potent?
Are you still talking?
Damn it, Clive. Wake up.
Hurt.
Sorry to wake you, but I think it may be time to leave. This place.
Once again, does my creation stray from the path laid before it? Steeped in conceit, you fancy yourself a god. You embrace Logos. But we will put an end to this hubris.
What are you talking about?
In the halls of origin, does our true power quicken? And there shall you be made complete. Soon, Mythos, soon you will discover how little you know of suffering.
Thank you.
so the crystals are no more. Yet in their silence, a new song rings. Its chorus building, a crescendo as it enters its final movement, stirring those long aslumber to waking. And back to their origin.
Bloody crystals cracked. So where the hell are they? Oh, fuck me.
Is that ether?
What in good Grieger's name is going on?
This is wrong.
Are we back?
Clive! Joshua!
Jill! Is everyone all right?
We're fine. What happened?
Too much to explain here.
Mate! We're leaving! Now! Everyone, fall back to the ship!
I will be with you anon.
Thank you.